Hi, we're in Yichang, Hubei Province, China, and we're going to visit the Three Gorges Dam. It's the largest hydropower dam in the world. We're getting there on a ship, and this is a very special ship. It's no ordinary ship. This ship is a fully electric ship. Made by CATL, and I visited the CATL factory. If you want to see that video, check it out here. But it's just unbelievable how smooth, how quiet, and above all, it's environmentally friendly. So let's go check out the ship together.
Okay, so this is the battery room.
So this is my power bank, and this is the ship's power bank. As you can see, there's a bit of a difference in size. This could charge my phone 350,000 times. This one about once or twice, maybe. So as you can see, there's 1, 2, 3 banks of batteries, and this is what powers the ship. It's a completely electric ship. And as I understand, in Yichang, they've installed a number of both fast, high voltage, and slow charging stations that these ships can dock at. These particular batteries will take the ship approximately 100 kilometers on a charge. So that's enough for a round trip for all the tourists that embark on this ship. So this being one of the most modern ships of today, you can see here, they have a full set of instruments and literally they can monitor everything about the ship from this control panel. Now, that's not the case with older ships. They would get some information, then they would have to physically go and inspect the area where there may be a problem. But here, they literally have all the information right in front of them. And that allows them to make much better and faster decisions if there is a problem. So this just shows you how, you know, Chinese shipbuilders are really advancing much quicker than a lot of people think. I mean, this is very, very impressive. It's actually like being in a spaceship almost. You wouldn't believe you're in a ship. Really, really impressive. So as you can see behind me, we're approaching a dam, and these are the lock gates. And this is the Gorges Dam, and it's actually the oldest project hydropower station on the Yangtze River. And then later on, we'll be approaching the main Three Gorges Dam after lunch. You can see the clearance down here is very, very tight. There's very little room for a mistake. The captain of the ship really has to have some amazing skill to navigate this ship into that lot, because he has very little clearance either side. So he must be absolutely spot on so he doesn't hit the sides of the lock. So it just shows you how smart the captains, but I'm sure ships of this kind, these modern ships, they probably have some kind of sensors on the side that helps him guide the ship into the lock. So you can now see we're actually entering the lock, and if you look on the walls, you can see that where the walls are wet and dry, and where it's wet, that's the level we will raise the ship to, which is the level of the water at the other side of the lock. Then once we've raised to that level, actually first they will close the doors behind us, and they will raise the level of the water. Then once the level is at the correct height, they will open these front gates and we will sail out. And that means we've gone up the level of the river and onward our journey. So as you can see, we're now sailing into the gorge, and something really interesting is that in this particular area of the Yangtze River, the Yichang area, 40% of all the tourist vessels are fully electric. And just this vessel alone, since its operation began around 2 years ago, it's saved 490 tons of oil fuel. And it's lessened the carbon emissions by 15,000 tons. Another feature of this ship, it has a lot of sensors and a level of artificial intelligence to really aid captain in this ship. Actually, when we were at the dock, the ship next to us was a completely AI ship. The captain is there just to oversee. It actually navigates and drives itself even through the lock, I believe. And that's something that, like, you know, just in 2 years, they've advanced from a sort of semi-A autonomous ship to a fully autonomous ship. And that's kind of the speed things move here in China. They don't just talk about it, they do it. And that's really amazing.
So right behind me is the reservoir to the dam. And when they built this dam, it was very controversial because it actually displaced 1.3 million people, and many villages had to be submerged under the water. And the statistics for this reservoir are mind-blowing. And it has a staggering capacity of 39 billion cubic meters of water. That is absolutely phenomenal. The length of the reservoir is 600 kilometers, and it has a surface area of 1,084 square kilometers. That is probably one of the largest bodies of man-made water ever, I would imagine. That's just colossal. So behind me is one of these 10 locks that the ships traverse the dam in, and this one is upstream. They have a total of 10. And there's 5 for upstream and 5 for downstream. So they can handle like 10 ships at any one time, 5 in each direction. And the water in the reservoir is actually 113 meters higher than the downstream water. So each of the 5 locks is around about 20 plus meters it lifts the vessel. And the maximum weight of a ship that can traverse this lock system using the ship lift is 3,000 tons. It actually opened about 6 months after the dam opened, so there was a small period of time where there was no shipping able to traverse the dam. And each one has 5 stages. It takes approximately 3.5 hours per ship to pass through. And they actually pass through free of charge. There's actually no charge for the ships to pass through the dam at all. In 2023, 168 million tons of cargo passed through the dam. That's kind of a staggering amount of cargo. So behind me is the famous Three Gorges Dam. And this was originally built to prevent flooding down the Yangtze River. In the past, there'd been some major floods which had killed many hundreds of thousands, if not millions of people. So that was the first reason the Three Gorges Dam was built. But as a consequence, it became a large power generating hydropower station. And today, it has an installed capacity of 22.5 megawatts. And that's powered by 32 700 megawatt turbines, which are the main turbines. And then there's additional 2 50 megawatt turbines. However, those 50 megawatt turbines are used just to provide operational power for the dam itself. Now, this time, there's not a lot of activity you can see from the dam. In fact, the water that turns the turbines exits the dam 20 meters below the water surface. But last time I was here, it was about 3 years ago, the sluice gates were open. There's a lot of water coming through these sluice gates. And that's because last time the water in the reservoir behind the dam was much higher. And they vary that water level at different times of year. So right now it's a little low because they were sort of lowering the water level in the reservoir behind, because this time of year is a sort of more rainy season. So they were preparing for heavier rains. Actually, this dam protects a lot of the cities downstream in the Yangtze River. For me, it seems how important that decision must have been to take, to actually undertake this project, because it cost $28 billion. And that was almost 30 years ago when they started building. So it was probably one of the highest cost projects, I would imagine, ever undertaken in China at that time. But I think the people who did that were absolutely right, because it's proven to be a major success. Not only does it generate a huge amount of power for the grid, but it also protects a lot of people from flooding further downstream. So this gentleman here has been our tour guide today. Well, a little earlier he was telling me some stories, because he's actually from this area. And I'd like to just recall, you were telling me a little bit of a story about when you were young when they first started building the dam. And then later you told me about how they actually filled the reservoir. So just tell me a little bit about that story.
When I worked as a guide in 2003, so in upstream, in the front side of the dam wall, so we just use 2 weeks to rise up water from the around 19.2 to 135.
Wow.
So I remember about just 2 weeks ago, I can see the towns, the villages, the houses, the streets, the roads, just on the bottom of us. But 2 weeks later, it's all covered. It's gone.
All a big lake.
Yes.
A big reservoir.
And then the river covered the half of the hill.
Wow. Wow, that's amazing. And they actually moved 1.3 million people, didn't they?
That's right.
To immigrate. For the reservoir, because I believe it goes maybe 600 kilometers long.
That's
the
right.
Reservoir. That is absolutely huge.
Yes, that is a huge work.
Yeah.
And that's also, that is a part of the projects. And we should say those 1.3 million local people, and most of them are the farmers, they sacrifice themselves, and for the rest of the country, they can use the clean and green power. So they sacrifice themselves, they move from their hometown to another places, and now they separate in every corner of China. So when I was a kid, my grandparents and my parents, so they came to the construction sites of the first hydropower project, Gorjoba Dam. So they came to their construction sites that assist the country or the government to move the rocks, shake sands, and to do all the things they can do. So when I was a kid, when I walked on the streets, hand by hand by my parents or my grandparents, they always told me that, Billy, please look, this road was built by us.
Wow.
And look, that building was made by us as well.
Helped to build
and
it.
And also,
well,
you know, in the 1970s, in the mainland China, people only had one day as weekend, just Sunday. People have to work on Saturdays. But the local people, like my parents, my grandparents, they would like to give up that weekend and took their lunchbox at home, came to the construction site to help the country to build the first dam in their hometown. They felt very proud of that.
So they should. That's a really touching story. It's quite emotional to think about that.
Yes, very strong passion about they are the master of the new China.
Yeah, I mean, it is. It's a phenomenal project. It even like blows my mind today to think they built this all those years ago. And if you look then, they had not the technology had of today. You know, it would have been much easier to build today, but they built. But I think we have to remember, right? Centuries ago, Chinese people built the Great Wall.
Yes.
So the dam is kind of a small project compared to that, right?
Right, absolutely, yes. So we have the tradition.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's been really interesting hearing your stories today. You may or may not be aware, I will be doing a video about this, but China have just announced that they will be building an even bigger project in the Tibetan Plateau, but that will be a different kind of dam to this. But it will actually produce approximately 3 times the electricity this dam produces. Anyway, I hope you liked that video of the Three Gorges Dam. It really excites me. I'm an engineer at heart and I really, really love this kind of thing. So if you do like this kind of content, give it a thumbs up. If you like the channel in general, please hit that subscribe button. But as always, from the Three Gorges Dam here in Hubei Province, Yichang, for now, take care.